Kick off this tutorial, let's use this Tarte Clean Slate poreless thing. Clearly I've used a lot of it, it's pretty skinny now, but I'm just gonna take a pea size of that. It's like clear and jelly, and I'm going to push this onto my nose, cheeks, chin, and forehead, and it's going to blur out my pores, supposedly. For foundation, I'm not sure which color is mine. It might not be either, but I'm gonna use these L'Oreal 24-Hour Foundation Infallible Matte Pro. I'm going to mix these two colors, 103 and 104, on the back of my hand. I don't have a fancy mixing palette. Honestly, they both look like the same exact color, but we're gonna pretend that they're different. And then I'm going to take this Morphe blending sponge and I'm going to blend it out. And how I blend with the sponge is I get it very, very wet and then I wring all the water out. And then as I'm blending, I'm just pushing down and pulling right back up. So a bunch of tapping motions. If you're gonna swipe and swirl, you're gonna see all those lines on your face. So tapping works the best. For a cream contour, I'm going to take this LA Girl Pro Conceal High Definition Concealer in the color Beautiful Bronze. This stuff is intense, so make sure you use just a little bit. I'm going to put it right here and the other side, right underneath my lip to give it that pouty look, right up here in my temples. I don't do a line across my forehead because I like to blend from temple to temple. Maybe on my jaw, just a little bit. And then I'm going to use my Real Techniques sculpting brush and I'm going to pat this out. I like to pat it because if I swirl it around or drag the product, it'll disrupt your foundation too. So you just gotta be patient and tap it out. For concealer, I'm going to use another LA Girl Pro Conceal, but this one is in the color Natural. They actually have like a ton of these Pro Concealers. Like I have 4 of them, and on their website, if you go, there's like 30. There's a ton. It's like a box this big of shades. So there's a shade for you out there. Guarantee it. And I'm just going to put this right under my eyes. On my chin, right on my Cupid's bow, exclamation point on my nose, and then in between my brows on my forehead. And then to blend this out, I'm gonna go back into my sponge and tap it out. To set my concealer, I'm going to use this Laura Mercier Secret Translucent Powder. This stuff is magic. It is way more expensive than the Airspun. The Airspun is way cheaper and you get a lot more of it. And it works just as good. Just feeling extra, you know? I'm going to use my sponge. I'm just going to pick some of that up and tap it under my under eyes. And it's going to lock that concealer in place. And I'm going to go around my nose. I'm going to set my chin. And my forehead. And then without dipping back into the powder, I'm just going to distribute the powder, what's left, on my sponge to the rest of my face. To make myself look really bronzy and glowy, I'm going to use this MAC Give Me Sun. It is pretty orange, so you want to use a really light hand, and I'm going to use this Real Techniques multitasking brush. I'm going to lightly give myself a sun-kissed glow. I'm going to go around the perimeter of my face, so you can picture that 3 perimeter, or you can just do spots that you want to do, like your cheeks. And to contour just this inside, I'm not going to bring it as far as my bronzer. I'm going to use the Hoola Benefit Bronzer and this Morphe brush. It doesn't have a name on it. I'm just going to pull my hair back and just make a shadow right at the base of this bronzer area. To highlight my cheekbones, I'm going to skip blush today. I don't feel like wearing blush, but I'm going to use the color Strobe. It's the lightest one in this Tarte Pro Glow palette. And I'm going to use this Morphe M510 brush. And I'm going to highlight the tops of my cheekbones and around my eyebrow. I'm also going to highlight my Cupid's bow, just a tiny bit on my chin, and then just the tip of my nose and down the bridge. And then just to make my highlight like a little bit more glittery, that one's more of a glow with from within, I'm going to use this Urban Decay Naked Illuminated in the color Luminous. Like this, and I'm gonna use a Morphe M310 fan brush, and this is just very like chunky and glittery, so I'm just gonna put that right at the tops of my cheekbones. So today I want to film a halo eye with maybe some pink or purple glitter in the middle, and the palette I'm gonna use is this Urban Decay and Gwen Stefani palette. Every time I do a halo eye, I go for this palette. I don't really know why, but it's a good palette to have. I love all the colors in it. So to start, I'm going to take a Morphe E27 brush, and I'm going to pick up the color Stark. It's like a baby pink. Good color for a base, and I'm just going to place that on the outside and on the inside. And then slowly connecting them at the farthest top of my eye. Next, I'm going to take the color Anaheim. It's a very cool tone brown color on this brush that does not have a name, but it's fluffy and tapered. I'm going to specifically place that on the outside and on the inside, and I'm not going to connect them yet. Yeah. The color that you place down first when you're starting your halo eye, so in my case Anaheim, is the color that you want to be the biggest, because then slowly you're going to make darker colors and they're going to be smaller, so it's like a nice transition when it comes out. And then once you like the buildup of your color, you're not going to pick up any more product and you're just going to lightly connect them at the very top. Now that you look like you have skeleton eyes, we're going to pick up the colors Zone and Punk. Zone is a warm tone brown and Punk is a very deep red. And I'm going to use the small end of this Anastasia brush. I'm going to mix them together and I'm going to specifically place them on the outside and then the inside, and then I'm going to blend them out with a fluffier brush. But I want to place the color down first and then blend it out. And I'm going to do the same thing with the inside. I'm going to place the color right at the bottom and then I'm going to blend it out. Eyes watering. No. And then with the tiniest color of blackout, guess what color it is? On this little pencil brush, I'm just going to lightly use black, because using a black color in your eyeshadow can go one or two ways. Good, you know, like, wow, I did a good job, or I wanna fucking start over. And I'm going to blend it out with a very clean brush. And then for this center part that I left blank, I'm going to take the color Baby. It's like a sparkly pink color. And I'm going to place this in the center. And when you take it high up past your crease is what makes your eye look very large. And I'm just going to tap that in. And then to take it just a couple steps farther, I'm going to use this Stila. It's a Magnificent Metals eyeshadow in the color Dusty Rose. It's just this tiny little thing, but ooh, girl. And I'm going to use my ring finger. Your ring finger applies the least amount of pressure. I'm just going to pick up a little bit, and I'm just going to pat this right in the center. And because I am that extra, I'm going to use this NYX glitter in the color GL02. It's like a purple and pink, and I'm just going to stick that right on top of that glitter that we put down, and I'm going to use this Morphe M224 brush. I'm just going to pick some of that up and tap some of that glitter right on top. And what this glitter is going to do? The most. The glitter is going to do the absolute most. And then with this tiny little M5114 brush, I'm going to pick up Anaheim and Zone, some of those browner colors, and I'm going to lightly blend the edges. And then I'm going to repeat all of those colors on my lower lash line, starting with the darker colors and then blowing it out to the lighter colors. So I'm going to pick up Punk and Zone. I'm going to put this right up against my lash line. And then I'm going to take Anaheim and Stark, and I'm going to blend that color out. Now with the color Skimp, I'm going to highlight my inner corner. And then in my waterline, I'm going to put this gel liner in the color Swerve. It's from ColourPop, and this little angled brush. And I'm just going to pull down my waterline. And then I'm going to add a thin thing of eyeliner. What the fuck am I talking about? Just at the top, no wing, just enough to cover my lashes. And this is the NYX Collection Liquid Black Liner. Like this. And then for mascara, I'm going to put on my L'Oreal Telescopic Carbon Black Mascara. Only kind of lashes I like, New Bounce and Bellas. They're perfect. Just the difference lashes make to a look. Oh my god. So for a lip, you could go a few ways. You could use like bright purple lip or nude. It looks good with anything. But I think I want to try and do this dark pink with a gloss over it. Let's see how it looks. So first I'm gonna start with this NYX pencil in the color Natural, and I'm just going to line my lips. And then I'm gonna go in with this NYX Liquid Suede Cream Lipstick in the color 09. I like these, but they do get dry and your lips will crack underneath. But it's still a pretty color, so whatever. And then I'm gonna put some gloss just in the center of my lips, and I'm gonna use this NYX Butter Gloss in the color Creme Brulee. And I'm just going to Alright, well thanks for watching this video. Yet again, I appreciate it. Please subscribe and like this video if you liked it. If you didn't like it, why'd you watch it? See you later.